How does Azure manage to build new APIs without breaking existing ones? Well, Azure's a little bit lucky because most Azure services are based on RESTful APIs, and RESTful API patterns, there's actually a version number that's typically encoded in the URL itself. And what that means is that whenever a client is talking to the service, the client tells the service exactly what version of the API they want to talk to. And that is an incredibly powerful hint from the client that lets them know, lets the service know what version of response they want to take. And so for any given API version, the service just always has to respond the same. But they can always deploy a new API version with new functionality, new behaviors. They can remove things, they can add new things, they can do whatever they want because it's a new API version. Clients are telling you exactly what API they want to talk to, and that gives the Azure service authors a huge opportunity to basically evolve their services over time. But they know that, you know, if clients talk in version 37, you're going to get the version 37 behavior, even if it's a year, two, three, whatever, out. Now, the Azure SDK on the client side also does versioning. And for the client SDKs, they use what's called semantic versioning. Semantic versioning, there's a major, minor, and patch or revision version number. And patch or revision means there's no new functionality. Minor says there's new functionality, but nothing's going to break. Major, those are breaking changes. And so you know when you adapt a new version of the package, you can tell from that version number whether you're going to get new functionality or not. In addition, the clients know about the service versions, and so the clients can correct and give you the service version that goes with the client APIs that you call.